Here's the next lesson that I got at this high school. I wrote it down. The enemy is an accuser, but God is a defender. And I say that because I was looking at all these kids. I'm kind of like, yo, these kids be wild. Like, we were in the neighborhood we were in, you know, these kids express themselves a little differently, let's just say. And I was just so, like, disturbed at their behavior. They have a presentation, and it's a dope that they get to be in this assembly. And I'm just looking like, y'all can't just chill for 2 moments to enjoy the assembly, whatever. And I just went into this place of so kind of confused that I was going to lean over to one of the teachers that said, like, these kids are crazy, right? And immediately God showed me a vision. And he showed me doing that in a sense. And then the professor looked back at me and said, excuse me, don't talk about these kids. These are our kids. You don't know them. Mind you, he recognizes the same craziness that's going on. But he's looking at me like, first of all, you don't walk with them. You don't really know them. Don't come in here and try to accuse them. You don't know them. Yeah, I'll deal with them later, but you don't talk about my kids. And that's the same thing with God. The enemy will literally try to come in and accuse, you know, make you feel less than, worthless. And he may be right. Your behavior may be left. But God's like, I'll judge them. You stay in your place. You don't walk with them. You don't love them. You're not here trying to help them, so you can't speak. And if you're not in a place where you're going to help somebody, but you're only going to talk about them, condemn them, or judge them, you are an accuser. And that makes you like the enemy, because the enemy is the accuser of the brethren. So if you're going to accuse somebody, and I'm talking to myself because in that moment I was looking at them kids like, but if you're going to accuse somebody, that's the first sign that you may be judging. Number one. Two, that you actually don't walk with them. It's something I learned even in this previous season, that when people condemn you or people judge you, it's because they don't know you. When you know somebody, your first instinct isn't to judge or condemn. It's to assist or to help, correct, and just love on even more. But only time you see somebody really getting condemned hard or judged or people talking about them or persecuting them is because they don't know them. And that's the truth. So it's like, you know, unfortunately I was the issue or the accuser in that moment, but God just showed me that vision. I was like, wow, that's deep. Like, I was literally about to lean over and go, man, these kids are crazy, right? And he just showed me, him kind of looking at me like, who are you? Don't come in here talking about these kids. Walk with them for a few days, then talk. Assist them, then talk. And it was kind of like, well, thank God I didn't say nothing. And it made me think about me though. Like, if anybody came and talked about our kids at the youth, I'm gonna be like, excuse me, you don't know them. I may not be validating that reaction that they're doing right now, but don't just come in here and just accuse them of stuff. You don't even know who they are. That's wrong. And again, we don't want to be accusers, but we want to love people and encourage people. And it was kind of like, it was really dope. It was really dope. So that was another lesson that I kind of got from that. And I think that was dope. And if I was going to say, even if I can offer something to somebody that really would help them, if you're in a place where you're accusing people, or you're talking about people, or you're judging people, or you're condemning people, or you're persecuting people, or you're something, even if you're just kind of like, you know, just gossiping about people, like, I would say, well, number one, pray. Number two, check your stance on how much you're doing in you know, in your part. Like, if you're not doing something to help, you're a hindrance, and there's no reason. I always say that when people used to look at the news and complain about things that they see. Don't complain if you're not moving or praying for a situation. It's just no point. There's literally no point. People that complain are usually the people that don't do no work. If you're working to assist or fix or solve a problem, you have no time to complain. That's just it. Like, that's just something that I learned. It was really good.